Well, it's been an eventful week in Vancouver with a number of player transactions and Ryan Kesler going back on the injured list with a broken foot. And the Canucks now bidding for their first win at Rogers Arena since February 7th to Jim Houston and Craig Simpson in the broadcast booth. Jim.
Thank you, Scott. Well, now comes the real puck drop as the Cup champions are in Vancouver for the first time since the 22nd of April last year when they eliminated the Canucks. Jonathan Quick, the Kings Conn Smythe goaltender, is gradually getting back to his stingy normal self after surgery in the offseason. 26th in the league in save percentage, but you know that that's going to get better. Corey Schneider gets a second consecutive start. He's given up three or more in four straight and welcomes consecutive starts to set that right. Referees for tonight's game, Greg Kimmerly and Kelly Sutherland is a BC native from Richmond. Henrik Sedin at center, Daniel Sedin on the left wing, and Alex Burrows on the right side for Vancouver against Anze Kopitar. Justin Williams and Dustin Brown, the captain of the Kings, a line that was together through the Cup Final. Here's Kopitar hooked from behind, and the Canucks are going to start this game shorthanded as Henrik Sedin will go off. And Kopitar plays the puck across the ice. The goaltender's out for the extra attacker, and there'll be a first-minute penalty against Vancouver, unless they can keep this going for a while. As Mike Richards came off the bench, and he does a button hook at his own blue line and a regroup here. Kopitar plays the puck to Williams, to Richards, fires the shot, and Schneider made the save, and finally the whistle goes, and Henrik Sedin will head to the penalty box.
And it's strength against strength, the top two lines going head-to-head, and you can see just a little bit of an outside move by Kopitar. Flat-footed was Henrik Sedin, and the big body of Kopitar forced him to get the stick into the hands. Crowd didn't like it early. And Jim, so often a power play early on, so hard to get yourself focused, you're not really in the game. A lot easier to kill in the first minute of a game than get right on the offensive part.
I think if I had my choice, I'd want to be on power play.
Correct.
Richards is out on it. Dustin Brown, Anze Kopitar, and Jeff Carter. Carter scored in five consecutive games and has 11 on the season. And Drew Doughty on the point with Mike Richards, so four forwards and a very mobile D-man. Dan Hamhuis broke up a play and sends the puck down the ice. With Ryan Kesler out of the lineup, the Canucks are missing not only a good center, but a good penalty killer. Kopitar tried to gain the line himself. Hansen couldn't hook the puck away. It hit a skate. Hamhuis in a bid for the puck with Jeff Carter. Kopitar spins and deals to Doughty on the other side. Richards, as the crowd forms, side of the net pass for Dustin Brown, and he can't relay to Carter, who has to come and get the puck. Doughty's got some room, slap pass, and just like the Sedins, he tried that, but it didn't work. And the puck deflected into the corner. Here's a chance for Higgins. Shorthanded. Missed the net. Chris Higgins with an excellent chance to make it a 1-0 game with a shorthanded goal.
A dead tired forward back on D.
Here's Dustin Penner, stops up and shoots. Jared Stoll was there for a rebound, but it didn't come to him. Now Mason Raymond takes off the other way in the back half of this penalty to Henrik Sedin, who's off for hooking. That's Jake Muzzin, one of three new young defensemen the Kings have to play because, well, their luck ran out. They had all those defensemen that were in the lineup every night. For 50 straight games, they played with the same six defensemen last season, and now they've got three of them out.
Well, having a forward on the point and the power play almost cost them here. You can see a flat-footed Richards thinks he's going to get a pass. Instead, he's got nothing left in the tank. An easy play for Higgins to get by, but that rushed shot, a little bit of pressure from Doughty, just forced him to hurry that shot. The player's now watching it on the screen, and had a chance to test Jonathan Quick and just put it a little bit too hot. There's Kevin Bieksa back in the lineup after missing two games, and he's doing what he does best, being an agitator, having a little discussion now.
Fighting for his territory in a neutral zone faceoff with Justin Williams.
Well, look at the Canucks losing the two games that he was out, giving up 12 goals, so he settles this defensive pairings down quite a bit being back in the lineup.
They really need the right-handed shot. He's very comfortable, obviously, playing on that right side. They have some lefties who don't particularly like it over there. Well, the power play continues for Los Angeles. Williams is straight up the middle, makes a move, can't make the shot, and he went down, and there's no arm in the air.
Mike Williams is looking for a call, don't you think?
I think the Canucks might have been looking for a call against him. He went down pretty easily as he went through there, but no call. Henrik Sedin set to come back on. And now a whole bunch of players who don't get to play on the power play are on the penalty kill will get a chance to get into this game that is now 3 minutes old with pretty much the same players playing.
Here's an opportunity, though, the top line of the Canucks coming off the kill to try to get a matchup win.
Henrik and Daniel Sedin with Burrows. That's Jordan Nolan out on this fourth line with Colin Fraser and Kyle Clifford for Los Angeles. Here's Daniel Sedin, now up to 21st in NHL scoring, and he was in the 50s a couple of weeks ago. Alex Burrows is there with it. Fraser trying to break the play up. Puck squirts out front. Burrows decides not to shoot, but he's got control. Daniel's in front. In comes Ham Hughes. Wrap around. Quick stop that. Ham Hughes couldn't get a hold of the puck in front of the net. Henrik to Daniel. And back. Doughty's trying to break the cycle. Burrows comes over to help. He's got nowhere to go, so he threw the puck at the net. Doughty knocked it away, but not out. Here's Henrik Sedin looking for an outlet. He's got one back at the blue line, but he hangs onto the puck. Side of the net. Burrows right in front. Score! Dan Ham Hughes. What patience. And Dan Ham Hughes finished the play. Vancouver has a 1-0 lead.
Well, you mentioned the patience. Burrows wanted this shot as a one-timer. He had his stick tickling the rafters here as he wanted it down low. Had an opportunity to it, and then as Doughty can't clear the puck here, watch number 14. He's got a stick up. He wants the one-timer. Doesn't happen. And then an excellent pass, though, a little support pass, a backhander, and Ham Hughes on the back door. No chance at all for Jonathan Quick, and a great pass by Alex Burrows to make that happen.
So a good penalty kill, and then the big line came on right after the penalty kill and went to the attack. Got the matchup, as you pointed out, that they normally wouldn't have.
That's tough for Daryl Sutter. You get that early. Special teams and the same guys have all played. He trusts his fourth line. He doesn't like matching very much, but that time it ended up costing.
Girls and Henrik Sedin get the assists. Vancouver with the lead. Here's Alex Edler with his shot. Quick saw that, or at least was in position to have it hit it. And Jeff Carter and Davis Drewiski team to get the puck out for Los Angeles. Old game at 3:43 of the first period. Here's David Booth into Vancouver. He's checked by Davis Drewiski. Jarrett Stoll hovering around the center in support. Dustin Penner, Dwight King on this forward line for Los Angeles against Max Lapierre, David Booth, and Dale Weiss. Here's a pass for Penner, and he's just offside. These teams have met once this season already. It was early, so it's really hard to get a read on either of them at that point. A 3-2 shootout win for Los Angeles after the start of this short season. Now we're almost at the halfway mark, and most teams have had a chance to figure out what they're going to be like. And for a lot of teams, that's going to be hurt and missing some guys for most of the season. Jarrett Stoll's in after the puck as the Kings get it deep. Penner and King with him. There's Tom Sestito, newest member of the Vancouver Canucks, wearing number 29. Big winger picked up from Philadelphia on waivers. And big is right, 6'5", gives them some real size. Wasn't playing a lot of minutes when he was in Philadelphia. There's a shoot-in, Dustin Brown. He and Kopitar and Williams back on. Justin Williams, Slava Voynov takes the shot, and Corey Schneider made the save and makes sure that there was nothing leaking around him after he stopped the puck.
You mentioned change. Aaron Volpatti gone, picked up on the waiver wire, and Tom Sestito, 6'5", as you mentioned. So what's he got to do? Well, you got to take some hits, you got to make some hits. And early on, getting his first shift as a member of the Vancouver Canucks, you know it's such a change. Just arrived here, you got a 3-hour time zone difference. You know that his blood's pumping pretty hot right now. He doesn't have to worry about scoring goals, but he does just play a physical game and get involved.
They had to get him in the lineup because they've only got 12 forwards. Got here late last night as Williams takes a shot. Schneider the save, and another one on Dustin Brown on the rebound. Williams again with a pass that's picked off as the top lines go head-to-head, and here comes Henrik Sedin to Daniel. A pass to Bieksa, and reaching in with Justin Williams, and he tipped the puck out of play, and He and Kevin BX are renew acquaintances. Looks like they'll be at each other all night.
Yeah, this should be a great matchup. Both these lines have such great support. And you see the little support by Williams. He kicks out. He knows Kopitar sees him. It's a good one-time shot. And just a little bit late to the front of the net was Brown. You can see he got boxed out. The rebound was there for a split second, but Schneider able to follow it across. And these two lines have such creativity. Schneider getting the call tonight, and I think for Alain Vigneault, Jim, a good opportunity after losing two in a row to have 3 days of practice, something that is so valuable in this shortened season. I think it came at a perfect time for the Vancouver Canucks to get their game back in order.
There's Mason Raymond out at center ice, an unusual position for him. And he lost his first faceoff here, but he's after the puck. Vancouver won the loss and had possession. Jason Garrison trying to keep the puck in, and he couldn't do it. There's the Mike Richards line out for Los Angeles. Carter and Trevor Lewis is the newest member of their line. He's been playing well, so he moved up a spot. Mason Raymond with Yannick Hansen and Chris Higgins. Here's Drew Doughty. Took a shot that Higgins blocked. A lot of guys, when they play minor hockey and end up in professional hockey, have at some point played center. Mason Raymond has not. Even as a junior and in college, he was a winger. But he sees the ice pretty well, and he's playing the center ice position tonight. There's Garrison, straight up the middle. Raymond chugging along behind to join him. Higgins is there as well, and he takes the pass off the boards to the net, and that's denied by Trevor Lewis.
I don't think Garrison realized that he had a forward back. That was Jared Stoll back on defense, so I think he might have been able to force a little bit more aggressively. Instead, he tried to make a cross-seam pass.
There's Tanev Nikasian, who's tripped up, and now there's an arm in the air, and it'll be a penalty against the Los Angeles Kings. So the Vancouver Canucks will get their first power play of the game as Jarrett Stoll goes to the penalty box on Hockey Night in Canada on CBC from Vancouver. Back in Vancouver, the Canucks have a 1-0 lead. They started the game, Craig, with a good penalty kill. Now they get a power play to extend their lead against the Cup champs.
And if you're going to beat the champions, you have to get your special teams going. And that's exactly what they had the opportunity to do here. You can see Jarrett Stoll going after the puck, and Aaron Stick knocks him down. The power play for the Vancouver Canucks, though, watch here early on. Try to get some traffic in front of Jonathan Quick. He sees the puck so well. He's got such great athleticism. I would expect to be a crowded crease in front of him.
Kopitar won the draw, but the Kings didn't get the puck out. Bieksa to Alex Edler off the boards. He hesitated a moment, and now he keeps the puck in. Set line of Sedin Burrows up front. And a good play with a stick by Anze Kopitar to knock the puck away from Daniel. And Dustin Brown to work it out to center. Canucks have had all sorts of different power plays, trying to make it one of the best in the business, but right now they're 12th in the league. Daniel Sedin leads them with 7 power play points. Edler to Bieksa. He'll drop the puck off to Alex Edler. On the outside, head up. Daniel Sedin takes the pass, and back to his brother. Burrows is open for a second in front. Bieksa from the blue line on the other side, and out. And Edler has to chase the puck. Daniel had to wait for Burrows to get onside. Edler to Daniel Sedin. The X is in front of the net. Daniel to Burrows, too hot to handle. Wraparound attempt, and Quick gets across. Trying to stop the puck at the post, and he did, and it's still loose. And finally covered up by Jonathan Quick.
Well, you can see the reaction of Quick there. He was worried for a second that it might have been under his foot and past the line, having a discussion with the official. But that Quick support, small passes into an area and then down and attack the net. Burrows had to adjust quickly, but you could see he tried to stuff it in, and watch the athleticism of Quick. Gets the skate right up against the post, and the puck was loose for a split second.
Canucks win the draw. Garrison with his shot went just wide of the net. Jordan Schrader, Mason Raymond, David Booth out on the second power play unit. Dan Hamhuis and Jason Garrison are the point men. And the Kings are able to clear the puck. LA's penalty killing 16th in the league.
Well, it's improving, though. 8 out of 10 in their last 3 games. And you think everything about their game is starting to get back on track.
They've won 5 in a row, 7 of 8. Hamhuis is back. Garrison, he was off the power play for a time here. Back on it now. Last dozen seconds of Vancouver's first power play. There's a crazy bounce out of the corner that almost worked. Straight back out of the corner. Mason Raymond was in front of the net, and the puck is cleared, and that'll do it in the penalty to Jarrett Stoll.
You see that play in the Vancouver corner there. That puck hit something along the boards and came right out. We'll have to watch for that later.
Chris Higgins up the middle. Yannick Hansen tips the puck in for Vancouver, and Quick is quick to play it. Canucks get the puck away from the Kings, and they'll hold it in the attacking zone. Voinov couldn't come up with it. Dwight King along the boards against a pinching Andrew Alberts. LaPierre with a shot just wide of the net. Chris Tanev on the other side holds the puck in. Got away from Rob Scuderi. Higgins to Hansen. LaPierre's in the slot. Yannick Hansen opens up some ice. He shoots and Scuderi blocked that. Tanev with a shot and Quick stopped that. Good pressure by Vancouver. Chris Tanev to the blue line. Alberts with his shot that went off the stick of Dwight King and out of play.
Well, Vancouver, with not having played since Tuesday, good jump to the start of this game. They're beating the Los Angeles Kings to some loose pucks. They're attacking the net. And you'll see on the back door, you saw the goal by Hamus. Well, here's Tanev as well coming down the side. Quick was equal to the task coming across. And Tanev ended up putting that shot wide. One thing you've seen early on here, Jim, is the Canucks have done a nice job of getting bodies in front of Jonathan Quick. Good net presence so far.
They look like they've had a couple of days off, don't they?
Yeah, rarely.
They look a little sharper.
Rarely do we see teams with that much rest.
Vancouver last played Tuesday. Los Angeles played Wednesday. So really no tired team in the game.
Well, one team's won five in a row, and the other team came off two losses. So I think Vancouver's a pretty determined bunch. And L.A., 8 out of 9 games at home. This is the one game on the road.
Crazy bounces and Burrows with a backhander that's stopped by Jonathan Quick, and Burrows has the puck again. BX's one-timer, he fanned, but Daniel Sedin couldn't bury it. Quick got across and trapped it underneath his body. Daniel Sedin had a wide-open net, at least he thought so. Vancouver looks sharp early on. They've scored one. Dan Hamhuis has it. Daniel with the gaping cage, and Quick made the save.
It's the newest Canuck, Tom Sestito, acquired on waivers yesterday in our bio, presented by Subway Restaurants. Maybe he was destined to be a Canuck. His first NHL goal he scored in this building on Roberto Luongo, got his second weeks later on Corey Schneider. He was drafted by Columbus at Rogers Arena in 06, played in the Memorial Cup in this building. Since two of his four goals have been scored on Luongo and Schneider, the question this morning was, did Sestito think the Canucks acquired him so their goaltenders could maintain their confidence? His answer, I was hoping the Canucks would scoop me up for that reason. So, Jim, we know he's got a sense of humor.
Indeed, he does. And you'd laugh at him or laugh at his jokes even if he didn't. He's a big man. Well, Vigneault with the last change is quite comfortable going head-to-head here with his top line. Guys made a change here and had Mason Raymond and Yannick Hansen, Chris Higgins come on against the Kopitar line for the time being.
Right. Part of that has to do with face-offs, too. It's an offensive zone face-off. Put Yannick Hansen, or Mason Raymond, rather, in a position where it's not a worry if you lose that draw.
Coming off the bench, Kyle Clifford with a shot. And Corey Schneider made the save. Vancouver's a little short at center ice. Manny Malhotra now on long-term injured reserve, and Ryan Kesler out, so they're a little thin down the middle.
Yeah, the Kesler and Malhotra issue obviously puts a lot of burden on Henrik Sedin, and what it means is you need him to play an offensive role. You don't always want to have him going in the defensive zone and having to take a draw, but the reality for Alain Vigneault, as you see here, he's got Jordan Schrader out. You're going to have to put younger players and inexperienced faceoff guys in this role and hope they grow into it.
Got two righties. He could use LaPierre there, and he trusts Jordan Schrader there, obviously.
Against the fourth line, too. And
we'll be,
as the matchup game once again.
We'll be surprised if we see Mason Raymond taking any in his own zone at all.
No, and he won't be doing it against Anze Kopitar either, like he did in the offensive zone.
So it's not as much of a problem at home as it would be on the road. Here's the first scrap for Tom Sestito. Jordan Nolan is a tough customer as well. And Sestito's been a scrapper in the Ontario Hockey League, in Plymouth, in the American League. And Jordan Nolan's had a couple of big bouts, including one that he won against Sheldon Surrey last Monday night.
That one Monday night really changed the game.
Absolutely.
Dustin Penner went out and scored the next shift after. And this is a response. Sestito with the big hit in the neutral zone. And Nolan came right after him. I think Sestito was expecting it too. The first shift was one he got himself comfortable. Nolan's going off to the room right now. Here's the initial hit. A hard hit on Fraser, knocked him down. He knew, looked around, saw Nolan coming across, a little bit of a jaw. Sestito actually initiated him. Boy, he got a couple of big ones off. Ever. But how about Nolan coming back? You got to credit him. He took a couple early and then fought back hard.
And he's had to go to the dressing room, and Sestito got a great round of applause from the fans in his new home.
Tough job in the National Hockey League playing that role, but when you're picked up on the waiver wire, you know you got an opportunity on a very good hockey team here in Vancouver to get a chance to play and to play a certain role. And here in his second shift, he makes everybody in this building stand up.
Five each for fighting to Nolan and Sestito. So no offsetting penalties and a faceoff in Los Angeles attacking zone. Richards will take it here against Max Lapierre. Dan Hamhuis has the puck. Chris Higgins up against Richards to try and clear it. Voinov kicked it into the front of the net. Hamhuis will try again to get out. Checked by Richards. Trevor Lewis is there. Richards gets the loose puck. Slava Voinov. His slap shot is blocked, and Higgins is able to clear the puck. Hansen is after Rob Scuderi. And a puck hit somebody at the Los Angeles bench when it was bounced off the board, so the play is stopped.
Well, you look at this Los Angeles Kings team, and they are the biggest of the teams in the National Hockey League. Everybody looking at the footprint of the last two Stanley Cup champions. The Kings, a big physical team. The Boston Bruins, the same type of team. And Daryl Sutter was saying that's what they're built on. And when you play this team, you've got to be able to compete physically and try to win some of those wars along the wall.
And they have to play the big body game. If they don't, they can be beaten. And Vancouver's advantage, wouldn't you say, is that they better use their speed against them tonight because they're not going to out-hit them.
No, and you got to make plays under pressure. If you can all of a sudden make those quick passes and support plays, they're a little bit late getting there, and then you pick them apart, and then you slow them down and don't allow them to play the physical game down low.
It's an interesting Western Conference right now because you've got Los Angeles and St. Louis and Nashville playing a big body game, and you've still got some skilled teams like Detroit, Vancouver, and Chicago. Presenting the Hockey Night second screen using a laptop, tablet, or smartphone, participate in trivia, polls, and games, interact and compete for cash prizes. Engage us at cbcsports.ca/second screen.
Here's a big faceoff for Mason Raymond here. He's on his strong side, but Jarrett Stoll is as well.
And Jarrett Stoll's real good, and he won it cleanly. And Drewiski takes the shot off the shoulder of Corey Schneider and off the glass. So the Kings got possession, but David Booth now gets the puck out through the neutral zone. Keaton Ellerby, another of the newcomers on defense over from Florida for Los Angeles. Paired right now with Drewiski. No Willie Mitchell, no Matt Green, no Alec Martinez.
That deal was February 8th of this year for that reason. It's been a big void, not only of experience, but also playmaking ability back there.
Zach Kassian got in a beat out an icing call. Dustin Penner back for the puck in his own zone. And he missed Anze Kopitar, so the puck will go the distance. And as Kevin Bieksa gets back, there's an icing call against L.A. They won't be able to change, and Alain Vigneault will.
Well, here Vigneault's got an opportunity to try to win this matchup, a little bit of a tired Los Angeles King line. But you think about the importance of the faceoff, and there was Mason Raymond. You have to put some faith in your players to allow them to, if they're going to put him in that role, allow him to try to play. But it'll be interesting to see how often after losing that draw, Raymond will get that chance in the defensive zone. I wouldn't think much.
Kings get out after the icing call. Justin Williams dumps the puck in. Kopitar forechecking against Schneider. And Kevin Bieksa moved the puck ahead to center. Jake Muzzin, 24-year-old from Woodstock, Ontario, paired on defense with Drew Doughty. Muzzin a late starter because in 2005 he had a couple of herniated discs surgically repaired in his back, and he basically lost a year.
How about him? I don't think anybody would expect him to be with Doughty. I mean, when the lockout was happening, he was a healthy scratch in the American League for a while.
Kopitar, slow to get up, and a penalty called in the play.
And Kevin Bieksa getting a earful from Justin Williams. Why not, though? Back in the lineup, be physical, and Kopitar slowly getting back.
It's an interference call, as you can hear, against Kevin Bieksa.
You mentioned the size of the Los Angeles Kings. Well, the puck had already gone, and he finished off his check. I think you have to play these guys with the physical body. And having had some great battles in two out of the last 3 years in the playoffs, those little wars around the walls are the ones that win you hockey games.
So a second power play for the LA Kings. They're 0 for 1. Canucks got the draw. Burrows couldn't clear the puck. It comes out front. Lapierre is there as all the Canucks are down around the net. And after getting control, Lapierre clears the puck to center. Voinov on the point. He's got Muzzin over on the left side to start this power play. Jeff Carter, Mike Richards, Trevor Lewis up front. Carter bounced the puck into himself. Down to the boards to Muzzin. He's got a pretty good shot. Lewis along the boards in a battle there. Too many Canucks. Garrison and Burrows team up to clear the puck. Voinov, Darryl Sutter says, has been his steadiest defenseman through the early part of the season. Whiskey with him now. Stole up the middle as Voinov decides to carry the puck, and then he flips it in. Edler knocked it out of the air, but right to Dustin Pennant. Jarrett Stoll. To the blue line, Drewski, one-timer by Voinov, and that's stopped by Corey Schneider. Tanner battles for the puck, three Kings behind the net. In comes Drewski, and they got the puck by him. But backing him up was Slava Voinov, and he's chased by Yannick Hansen.
Well, you can tell this penalty kill has a little bit more confidence. They're being very aggressive, as you can see Hansen pressuring even in the offensive zone. But they're just not allowing the Kings the easy setup, the time and the space. And that comes with, again, a couple more days of practice and a little bit more in sync on the penalty kick.
Well, down to the last 30 seconds of the extra penalty. Garrison takes his time and dumps the puck back in. Just the way the shifts work out because of who was on the ice for the penalty. The Kopitar line didn't get any time in this power play. Now they're getting out here with just a dozen seconds to go in it.
After watching Kopitar on the bench, I think he needed that time, though. Yeah. He still looked a little sluggish.
Williams straight up the middle takes a shot that Dan Hanhuis deflects out of play with 3 seconds to go in the penalty.
One thing early on for the Vancouver Canucks is their penalty killing surprisingly under 80%. A good start to this game, 1 for 1, almost 2. But you look at their success, the 2 President Trophy wins, their penalty killing was in the top 5 the 1 year and the top 10 the other. And I just think when this team is playing well, their special teams are such a factor.
Face-off win for Henrik Sedin, who doesn't kill much, but they need him there, and he won the draw. The penalty's over. BX is back on. Not a shot for LA on that power play. A couple of good penalty kills for Vancouver. Dustin Brown now with the Kings on the attack. In comes Jake Muzzin, but Andrew Alberts is there. Into the lineup tonight with Keith Ballard to scratch. Kopitar to Muzzin and over to Drew Doughty. 5-on-5 again as Kopitar goes up the middle. He's 1-on-4. Poke check by Bieksa. Dustin Brown follows him. And for Justin Williams out of his reach. Bieksa went at him again. Gave him a little bump.
They got a good thing going here, don't they?
Long memories. Here's Rob Scuderi with a shot. And Corey Schneider made the save. Zach Cassian. So his ice time fall to just over 6 minutes in the last game. In a while since he scored, he dumped the puck in. He's after Keaton Ellerby. Up the middle, Fraser had to get his head up. Higgins was right there. Big forecheck here by Vancouver. Ellerby again lofts the puck ahead. Fraser to Lewis. Cuts into the middle. Bieksa took the puck away and then gave it away. Fraser with a shot. Schneider with the save, and he covers up. With 3:14 to go in period number one, Vancouver's had a couple of good penalty kills, and Dan Hamhuis has their only goal. 1-0 Vancouver on Hockey Night in Canada on CBC. Early part of the game, Vancouver's leading 1-0. It's been pretty tidy around the Vancouver net.
Yeah, there's been some good battles. As you can see, Bieksa comes across, tries the clearing attempt, but then boxes out. And Schneider does a nice job on that rebound, and you can see the pushing and shoving. Fraser getting in it with Raymond. And these two teams, as so often, the playoffs really start to build the rivalry up, don't they?
Sure do. And Kevin BX has been everywhere in the early part of this game. Canucks needed him back in tonight. He's back after missing a couple of games. and involved everywhere.
I think what it does to the defensive pairings, as you mentioned, that right side, I think, well, you think of some big goals he's scored already this year, 5 goals in this shortened season. And, you know, defensively, he's got to play that style. He's got to be a burr in the side of the top players and the opponents. And so far, with that Kopitar line, he's done a nice job. He and Williams, as you mentioned, been at it about 5 or 6 times already.
There's a shooting for Vancouver's Lapierre line. He's out with Booth and Cassian. Lapierre, high support, takes the shot, and Jonathan Quick steered that aside. Cassian to Alberts. His shot wasn't a very good one, but he kept the puck in. Davis Drewski races after it, and he'll move the puck up the middle. A turnover. Booth. Here's Cassian. Takes a slap shot. Quick made the save, and he steered the puck up in the air and over the glass, out of play.
Well, what a veteran play by the goaltender Quick to get the faceoff there after a little bit of pressure. Cassian, another big body, gets to the front of the net. Watch Quick take a peek around him. And Cassian with the deflection tried to get it 5-hole, but Quick was right on the doorstep. Cassian, you think of how he started. Got an opportunity early on to play with the Sedins. You saw what he did. 5 goals in those first game, 8 games, and the goals have been hard to come by since. That was a good shift there.
Now Mason Raymond to face off in the attacking zone against Jeff Carter. Scramble draw, and the Kings get the puck. Richards, who's the center on the line, defers to Carter on that strong side for 77. Jeff Carter scored in 5 straight games. And in those 5 games, Mike Richards has assisted on 4 of the goals. The way it's supposed to be, center and winger, isn't it?
Yeah, the chemistry is really starting to go. You think last year for Carter, a difficult one going from Philly to Columbus and finding his way finally to the Los Angeles Kings, had just 21 goals, but he's looking much more like the 40-plus goal scorer he was a couple of years ago. And as you mentioned, 5 straight games, his career high is 6, so looking to equal that tonight.
Raymond gets waved up. Chris Higgins will come in and take the draw. Carter wins it. Raymond got in there in a hurry to help out. Higgins, nifty little play to Mason Raymond, and then Richards took the puck away. And Trevor Lewis is out to center. 1-on-2 with Carter steaming up to join him. Up the boards, Doughty held the puck in against Edler. And Corey Schneider makes the save and hangs on. Martin Short hosts the inaugural Canadian Screen Awards, a celebration to recognize the very best in Canadian film and television. That's tomorrow night at 8 on CBC-TV.
Jim, that last faceoff was a good example where you talked about the speed. If you're not going to win the physical game, Mason Raymond gets in there quickly off the loss and keeps the puck alive.
Just don't lose them cleanly. Make sure if you can, you can win the loss occasionally or scramble them like that one. There's Daniel Sedin. 3-on-2 at center. He's got Garrison heading for the net, and the shot goes wide. Garrison will go after it. He turns and fires, and Quick made the save. Daniel Sedin is right there. Burrows to Henrik Sedin. From behind the net, Daniel's wraparound was stopped by Quick, and Dustin Brown starts out with Williams and Kopitar trying to make it a 3-on-2. There's a penalty coming up here, and it'll be against Vancouver. And it'll be against Garrison for interference, and Los Angeles will get a power play for the 3rd time in the period.
Well, that's a tough shift for Garrison. I really think he's starting to find his game that he was offensively. Look at him take off the faceoff. He leaves 2 Los Angeles King forwards in his dust, gets involved offensively. But then on the way back, you be the judge. A little bit of a delay, not much of an arm, and you could hear the reaction of the crowd. They didn't like it right in front of the official there. Often you'll see that bump where a guy will engage. I didn't think he bumped him, maybe grabbed the arm a little bit. So an opportunity here again for the Kings on the power play.
Canucks penalty kill's been impeccable so far. They're testing fate with a 3rd penalty in the period. Doughty, Kopitar back at the right point right now. Here's Carter. Dustin Brown, sharp angle, stopped by Schneider. Tried to get him to lead that post a little bit with a fake to the front and then the shot, and it didn't work. Doughty chased by Max Lapierre. Richards takes over. Brown loops back to join him. Carter's right there on his right. Kopitar as well. Kopitar, now they're set up. Centering pass by Richards went off a leg. Carter turns. Kopitar with Brown screening. In the slot, Carter's trying to get open. He's a great shooter. Richards fakes. Now he takes it. Schneider, the save, the rebound, and Doughty put it up high and out of play with 46 seconds to go in the period.
The frustration continues for Drew Doughty. After seasons of 10, 11, and 16 goals, he's gone 22 games now without a goal. Tried to get that rebound, slid down the back door, and had to adjust his shot at the last second, as you can see, right off the bar and out, as Schneider came across and did a nice job of taking away the top half of the net, forced Doughty to go even higher.
So the faceoff stays in the attacking zone for LA. And Richards will face off against Max Lapierre. Richards got the draw. Carter to Kopitar, forced to his backhand. Carter with a shot that was blocked by Chris Tanev. And the Canucks had a chance to clear it, but Edler fanned. Richards to the front of the net. Carter trying to get position on Tanev and can't do it. Canucks again very aggressive on their penalty kill here, but the Kings keep the puck in. Williams to Kopitar. Tanev's after Carter. Along the boards. Burrows couldn't get the puck out. Richards draws Burrows towards him, then goes back to Justin Williams. His slap shot off the body, then off the post, and then out of play. And you could hear the clank coast to coast.
One guy thankful is Alex Burrows. He looked up skyward. He was frustrated. He couldn't get that puck out. A good battle along the boards here. He has one chance to clear it and can't. Good net presence in front. Look at both Carter and Kopitar. And this is just a rocket. Ringing that bell as Williams stepped into it. A little bit of a knuckler, hard off the post and out. Two on this power play so far.
Kings got the draw. Carter and Kopitar. And another shot that has tipped just wide of the net. Doughty in front. Could have been a disaster there. Alberts had that go off him almost into his own net. And the puck is cleared. The period comes to an end before the penalty does. There'll be a carryover of 31 seconds into the second period for the Los Angeles Kings on the power play. The shots on goal in the first period were 12-8 in favor of Los Angeles, but the only goal was scored by Dan Hamhuis at the 3:43 mark of the first period. Good start for Vancouver on home ice with a 1-0 lead. And in the building tonight, Don Cherry and Ron McLean. Let's go to them now.
Joe Wild, if you won't be tame, I treat you like a child, then you're going to be named another enemy, not even a friend of me, because you'll get fried in the end when you pretend to be.
Here at Rogers Arena, the Canucks holding on to a 1-0 lead with the Kings on the power play for at least another 31 seconds to start the second period. Jim and Craig pointed out in the first period this game is shaping up as the physicality of the Stanley Cup champion Kings against the speed of the Vancouver Canucks. And LA assistant coach Bill Ranford said between periods the message to the Kings players was start matching the speed of the Canuck players in order to spend some more time in the Vancouver zone. Now with the call of the second, Jim and Craig.
There's Jason Garrison sitting in the penalty box for another 31 seconds or less. You know, there's an old expression in hockey, it's a 60-minute game. I think in this short season, it's a 40-minute game. There's a whole bunch of teams trying to find 60, and the Los Angeles Kings are one of them. They've had a lot of games where they've had a good 40 minutes. Look at their game that they won the other night against Detroit. They weren't very good in the first period, but they got real good by the end of it.
They just don't give up many goals. I mean, all six of their last eight games, one is it.
Here's Chris Higgins, shorthanded. Lost control of the puck as it bounced on him, and Drew Doughty's back the other way. Jeff Carter off the wing, had a look around, fed the puck to Doughty. Dan Hamhuis stepped in front of Carter. Now it's a 3-on-2 in the corner, and Yannick Hansen comes up with the puck as Doughty backed off. Garrison's out of the penalty box. Big Jason Garrison couldn't get control of the puck. Great chance there for Vancouver. And now back to 5-on-5 in a 1-0 Vancouver lead. Rob Scuderi lays the puck in. Dustin Penner to win in forecheck against Kevin Bieksa. Good hit by Jarrett Stoll on Bieksa. Sedins have played almost exclusively against the Anze Kopitar line, but they're out against Jarrett Stoll right now. Dwight King. Slava Voynov. He gets double-teamed, and Burrows took the puck away. Up the middle, Alex Edler with a wrist shot that's blocked by King. He gets to the backhander and knocked it in, but not deep. And Voynov stepped up got to center and dumped the puck into Los Angeles. Requires a change here. Alexander Evan. Too hot to handle. Waist high as well. And that'll go all the way down the ice for an icing call against Vancouver.
Well, Kevin BX has had a very solid first period. 7 minutes, 45 seconds. Here's a great example of taking a hit to make a play. He knows he's got pressure. Is calm under the pressure. He absorbs the hit by Jared Stoll. But watch the little move. Doesn't give it away. Gives himself an extra second. Makes the outlet pass. And then quickly jumps back up and gets into play.
Henrik Sedin in his own zone won the faceoff. Los Angeles, as you might predict, had an advantage, winning 62% of the faceoffs in the first period. But that was a big win for Henrik, and now Jordan Schrader's come onto the ice in the midst of a Vancouver change. There's Tom Sestito going the wrong direction there, number 29 out on the left wing. Played just over a minute in the first period, couple of hits, fight. Used his time wisely, didn't he? Jordan Nolan for Colin Fraser, and he fanned off the heel of his stick, and BX clears the puck. Drew Doughty up the middle. Colin Fraser bounces the puck to center. And Chris Tanev took a bump, but he dumped the puck back in. The other number eight, Drew Doughty, he took a bump, and he got the puck to Dwight King at center. He'll dump the puck in. First man back is Chris Tanev. Sees Kyle Clifford coming. Made the play, took the hit, and the puck is out to center just out of the reach of Jordan Schrader. Now the diminutive center, number 45, gives the puck to Chris Tanev, who jumps up on the play. In behind the net. Crashing in there was Booth, and he couldn't come up with the puck. Race for the puck, and Dustin Penner made Corey Schneider plant. Penner out of the corner, slaps the puck onto the other side. In comes Ellerby with a shot. That missed the net. David Booth pokes the puck out to center. The pace seems to have picked up here at 5-on-5, don't you think, in the second period?
And you saw a big Dustin Penner there. He might not be the fastest from a standstill, but boy, when he gets moving, he gets going downhill fast. He had a good job of chasing down that icing there and keeping the play alive.
Kings are trying to pick up their pace of the game. Canucks have been pretty good since the start. Here's Lapierre. Zach Cassian dumps the puck in. Another change for Vancouver. 3.5 minutes into this second period.
And that's where those quick support passes, though, by the D of the Vancouver Canucks alleviate that pressure from the Kings.
Here comes Henrik Sedin just off the bench. Stops up. Beats Ham Hughes. His shot is stopped by Quick. And he pounced on the rebound before Alex Burrows could get to it. Little confusion on a change. And nobody picked up Dan Ham Hughes except Henrik Sedin.
Well, and you know that Henrik Sedin's going to find him. The leading assist man the last 3 years in the National Hockey League. Here's why. Just his head up, great presence of mind, and look at the aggressiveness of Jonathan Quick. Ham Hughes had to settle that puck down, take a quick look, a shuffle over, a telescopes out, and he makes not only the save, but grabs the rebound.
Harrison right off the draw, won by Henrik Sedin, and that puck went just wide of the net. And we're back to the matchup of the Sedin line against Kopitar. Here's Williams. Dustin Brown shot off of Jason Garrison's stick and up into the netting, out of play.
Well, you see Schneider shaking his legs there. This line has got so many different ways they can beat you. You saw Graves talk about Justin Williams and his big goals. Brown is such a physical presence, and Kopitar might not look like a big man, but he is deceptively big, hard to stop, and has such great range as well. He can pass the puck, and that's a good compliment on the side with Brown going hard to the net and Williams with a good shot.
Lewis helped out with a winger win here for Los Angeles, and now he gets run over in front of the net as he backhanded the puck in. Mike Richards watched by Lapierre. Cross ice, just got it through to Muzzin. Right in front, he wanted that tip, and it was by Doughty, the other defenseman, but wide. And BX up the boards. Carter into the middle. Yannick Hansen is there, and he tipped the puck by Muzzin. And now Doughty gets back before Yannick Hansen.
Yeah, it's not for trying that Doughty doesn't have a goal. Man, if you're that winger on his side, you have to have your head on a swivel, because he's going down every chance he gets to get involved offensively.
And he's on the ice a lot, 9 minutes in the first period. Plays all the power plays.
And he plays busy minutes, doesn't he? I mean, defensively he has to battle, but offensively he is jumping up the ice and he's skating miles.
He's not playing in the rocking chair, is he? Here's Chris Higgins. Hansen is offside. Higgins battling on the boards here with Penner and King. Jared Stoll got in between there and stole the puck. Gets it in deep. Up the boards, Keaton Ellerby takes a shot, and Corey Schneider had a little trouble with it, but he could see it all the way, and he trapped the puck and stopped the play.
Well, defensively, when you're playing against Doughty, if you're that left winger, take a look at the top right of your screen. He's just reading off of what Higgins is looking. Higgins is looking at the puck, so what does he do? He transforms, gets down low, and has an opportunity with the tip there from his partner, and then getting back. And here's the kind of ice time you were talking about, Jim. Third in the National Hockey League, and I'm sure that'll just continue to grow, especially at the absence of Green and Mitchell in this lineup. He's got 11:40 to this point.
Kings get another draw. Skuderi takes a shot into a crowd, but it was blocked by Tanev. He got bumped hard by Jordan Nolan. Voinov. Center Colin Fraser advanced the puck. Here's Kyle Clifford going wide on Tanev. And he protects the puck, put it up the boards, and then gets to it and keeps it in. Andrew Alberts off the boards again. The Canucks try and get out. Greg Clifford wreaked havoc on that shift, and now a penalty being called here, and it's against Alberts.
Well, the fans haven't been fans of the calls here at Rogers Arena, and you could see Alain Vigneault looking, smirking at that one.
It's a roughing call against Alberts on Kyle Clifford, who had a pretty good shift, didn't he?
Yeah, and you could see Alberts got hit there. Who hits who? Clifford wasn't expecting. You could see the puck goes past Alberts, and this is a reactionary one by Alberts, so he just blows him over. I think that little bit of a jump, you could see down at the bench now, we've got some jawing back and forth. Too bad Glenn Healy's not down there to give us the goods.
They picked up where they left off. And Roberto Luongo seems to be quite enjoying the conversation.
Well, let's face it, when you get into those playoff battles, that's what really creates the rivalries. You can have some good ones in the regular season, but when you've gone through a five-game loss like happened last year, here's the changes going on, the jawing. You can see a little jab there. Was that Kevin Bieksa's stick?
Yeah, I think it was on Colin Fraser.
Yeah, you got to be careful about that.
So another power play for the Los Angeles Kings, 0-for-3, but their last one was the best one so far. Kopitar, Williams, and Brown start up front. Muzzin and Voinov, the point man.
This is a hot and cold power play, though, Jim. They started the year 0-for-23, and all the top players really were struggling offensively early, and one of the reasons why they did get off to a slow start, they just couldn't get in and going on the power play.
Kopitar, what a nice move he made on Burrows to get in and get set up. He's got Dustin Brown in the slot, Williams in front of the net, Voinov to Muzzin, loads up and fires Schneider the save. The rebound almost went off one of his own players and in, and Schneider was quick to jump on the puck.
The key there too is Garrison's battle with Williams. He tied him up enough that he wasn't able to get his stick down. He allowed the goaltender to see the puck, allow the goaltender to fight for the rebound. Nifty move at the blue line by Kopitar, sets this play up, a little cross-seam pass, but watch the front of the net. Williams gets in great position here, but Garrison clears it for the shot and then gets the stick of Williams so that he can't get it down on the ice and get to that loose puck. Good job of boxing out by the defense.
Kopitar now wins the faceoff. Muzzin to Voinov. Into the middle, Kopitar kicks it back. Muzzin to Williams, he scores! What a hot shot by Justin Williams, and in its fourth try, the Los Angeles power play finally strikes, and it's a 1-1 game.
Well, precision passing there. You saw a good example of it the last time that Schneider made the nice save, but it's faceoffs. And in the first period, 62% were won by the Kings. Here's another one. A nice job by Kopitar. Look at the support. Short passes, quick passes, a fall down in front by Tanev, and just a rocket. The one-timer by Williams, a bit of a knuckler, a little bit of presence in front with a screen, but I think this one, look at right when it came on the stick of Williams. It turned up, and that was a knuckleballer for Schneider to handle.
Justin Williams, just his second of the season, and a power play goal. And how about the play of Jake Muzzin on the power play?
Calm, cool. And I really like that quick passing. I mean, it doesn't allow the penalty killers to get to those passing lanes or even get to the shooting lanes.
Looked like a poised veteran there, and he has to play like that with three defensemen, regulars out. So new game, 1-1, second period. You know the Canucks are tempting fate, whether you like those penalty calls or not. Tempting fate, you
yep.
go shorthanded four times against the Stanley Cup champs.
You can see a little bit more urgency, didn't you? I mean, their aggressiveness, and it comes from number 11. And Kopitar now 9 points in a five-game streak, and he was the catalyst on the play before, and he wins the draw and makes that one happen.
See if the Canucks can snatch the momentum back now. Here's Dwight King trying to keep it going for Los Angeles. Goes wide, he got five BXA into the slot. Dustin Penner can't shoot. Keaton Ellerby. In the midst of a change, Carter's just come on. The pass was intercepted by Penner. Might have been headed for Carter. Now Jeff Carter, a bouncing puck, he holds it into the line. Keaton Ellerby shoots it in. The Kings have to tag up. In comes Trevor Lewis. He ran into, there's a nice save by Schneider. He ran into Edler. The puck bounced to the front of the net. Here's Richards. The Kings are really coming on. Lewis alone in front of the net. Shot went wide. Richards wrap around to the front of the goal, and it's cleared away by Alex Edler.
Well, if Bill Ranford wanted his team to get skating more, they've answered the bell, haven't they? This is a desperate need for Vancouver to get an emotional shift. Right now, the white sweaters are just swarming the puck.
Here they come again, Trevor Lewis. Kopitar comes right back on. Up against Dan Hanhuis here. Bouncing puck, Muzzin. In the windup as he ran into Weiss, who lost his stick. Jake Muzzin and Drew Doughty up with the Kopitar line. Against the fourth line of the Vancouver Canucks. Kopitar up the middle. That was a suicide pass, and he didn't take it. Jason Garrison on the other side. Tom Sestia with a shoot-in. Schrader into forecheck. Muzzin's the first man back. Dustin Brown up the boards. Here comes Kopitar. Here comes Garrison right behind it. And the Canucks win that battle, and David Booth is out to center. Lapierre is with him. Dustin Brown came back and broke the play up. The play is stopped offside with 11:22 to go in this second period. Kings have tied it up on the second goal of the season for Justin Williams.
Well, the Vancouver coaching staff surely must lament the loss of Ryan Kesler. Missed the first 12 games to complete his recovery from shoulder and wrist surgery. Seems in his first game back on February 15th in Dallas, suffered a broken foot while blocking a shot. Because he's a warrior, Kesler tried to play through the pain. Two x-rays didn't reveal the broken bone. CT scan on Wednesday did, so Kesler played seven games with a broken foot. Now it's another 4 to 6 weeks of recovery for Kesler. Does his absence pressure Mike Gillis to make a trade for a center? Gillis has answered that question about 10 times already this week, but it won't prevent us from asking again on After Hours tonight, Jim.
So Ryan Kesler is a victim of modern technology.
Yeah.
The x-rays showed nothing. They finally got a CT scan. Had they not had that, he probably just would have kept playing until the pain went away. There's Jake Muzzin back in his own zone with Drew Doughty as the Canucks try to get back to the attack here. Kopitar lugs the puck to center. Muzzin's with him, tried to hold up, and he's just offside on the play.
Well, you're getting a real look at the strength of Anze Kopitar. And when he gets going, look at one hand on his stick here as he fights off check of Henrik Sedin, keeps his legs moving and ends up being offside. But this second period, his game has risen to another level. And you can see how he's gone. A little bit slow to start, but he has been on fire through the last 13 games.
There just aren't many players like Anze Kopitar in the NHL right now. Everybody's looking for a big center who's got skill and he can use his size. Very few of them like Kopitar. The puck has disappeared. It's out of play.
And Jim, what it does for Daryl Sutter, when you look down your bench, you can win some matchups. He's a handful. Then you come back with the Richards line, when Richards and Carter have been a great tandem together. Jared Stoll is a guy as a center iceman who can take key draws in the defensive zone, and the fourth line has been effective as well. That's really been their Stanley Cup formula that won for them last year, and this is virtually the same team and now starting to play like it.
They can get some ice time for their fourth line because two of them kill penalties. Lapierre for Vancouver number 40 with David Booth and Zach Cassian trying to get their cycle game going. Going off, lifted the stick of Booth. Bouncing puck for Stoll, and Cassian skated by and couldn't get it. Jared Stoll, who scored the series winning goal in overtime last spring for Los Angeles against Vancouver. And Dustin Penner and Blake King
Good battle by Tanev, but he doesn't have a stick, so should be talking to one of his forwards there and grabbing theirs if this puck comes out.
That may never happen. Tanner couldn't control it. He tripped on the discarded stick. In comes Richards off the bench. Alberts up against King. Still, Tanev hasn't got a stick, and nobody's given him one, and the puck is finally cleared. Keaton Ellerby.
He's got to go to the bench, too. I mean, Tanev had a chance to change there. Now Alberts is looking to give it to somebody, and his partner's got nothing to give it to.
He was in the right position. Here's Mason Raymond with some speed. Scores! Wow, did he step on the gas coming up the middle. Mason Raymond with speed and a great shot, and Vancouver's reclaimed the lead 2-1.
They just caught the defense of the Kings flat-footed at the line, and you're right, you're not going to catch him in full flight. But watch the play down low. Just a simple up the boards. Booth keeps it alive with the backhand. And a nifty pass by Hansen. A rolling puck and just a rocket. You can see Quick's reaction. He was in good position. He was outside the blue. This one just beat him up over the crook of the elbow. Great positioning as it went up quickly. You could see didn't go over the glove. Right over the elbow. And the hitch of the goaltender, Jonathan Quick. What a huge goal for the momentum swing in this game.
Yeah, they really needed that, didn't they? Raymond gets his sixth from Hansen and Booth at 10:32 in the second period. Let's see if they can build on that now.
Good for Booth to get his first point, being back in the lineup this fifth game.
Here's Mike Richards. He has a look around as he skates to center. Doughty once again is up to join him. Trevor Lewis shot wide. Doughty's right there. Centering pass, and it's knocked away by Schneider and Hamhuis, and all the way down the ice, and Quick will have to play.
You see Doughty again there. Man, that's a lot of hard minutes that he's playing. He just took off as fast as he could up the ice and was had Raymond chasing.
He's not going to save himself just because they've got some injuries. From behind the net, Yannick Hansen out front. Edler's shot, and a nice save by Quick. Great chance there, and Quick made a nice save, and Vancouver's turned this game again and taken over with the momentum. Henrik Sedin centering off a stick. Chris Tanev has one now. Watched by Kopitar. Henrik Sedin, long pass for Daniel. He'll chase the puck. Quick will come out to meet him just about in the no zone. Muzzin up the boards. Tanev couldn't hold it in.
It's amazing what one goal can do to a team, doesn't it? Lifts the bench up, gives them some life. Vancouver skating again. This one should really crank up to be a heck of a period.
Jonathan Quick sets the puck up for Voinoff. He looked up and lost the puck, and Burrows took it away. As Daniel with him, Henrik in the corner. The pass is for Daniel Sedin against Voinoff. Daniel back to Henrik. Burrows jumps in behind him. Rob Scuderi trying to handle Daniel Sedin is having a tough time. Henrik. Daniel fights to the front of the net. There's a pass in front. And it was a good chance for Andrew Alberts, but he just couldn't quite control it or make the pass. Here he comes again. Pinching in on King. Great shift for the Sedin line.
Nice check by Daniel Sedin, too, on Bueno. He was expecting that.
Off the boards. Here they come again. Henrik. Bieksa, his shot is blocked. Has to turn and be quick. Dustin Brown. Bieksa trying to keep him outside, and Corey Schneider made a nice blocker save on Dustin Brown. Good action now. Dale Weiss up the middle with a tip. Keaton Ellerby takes the puck. Davis Drewiski. Penner poke checked at center by Dale Weiss. Ellerby gets to center, and Bieksa had him lined up. One of the hip check. Schneider threw the puck into traffic from behind the net. Nolan scores. Oh, the puck got lost in the gridlock behind the net, and Corey Schneider got caught out of there, and Jordan Nolan made him pay 2-2.
And for Nolan, that's his first goal in 18 games, and just a miss there by Bieksa, a little miscommunication here. And you can see the exchange didn't go well between Schneider and Alberts. Then Alberts gets caught, and Schneider, puck going one way, he's going the other, and got his stick tied up in the net, couldn't get it across. Look at his stick right there. In the air, tries to dive across with the glove, but a heads-up play by Nolan, getting his second of the season.
So after perhaps the best shift of the game for Vancouver, they end up gift wrapping one for Los Angeles, and it's a 2-2 tie. Well, who gets the momentum now?
Well, these two teams have been trading it in this period for sure.
Trevor Lewis along the boards, working with Jarrett Stoll now, and Dustin Penner. Change is about to begin. Tanev took a hit from Jarrett Stoll. Cassian gets the puck in deep for Vancouver, and then goes after Drewski and pushes him hard to the boards. Ellerby to Lewis against the pinching Alex Edler. He gets caught, and Dustin Brown gets out to center but didn't get the return pass from Stoll.
Boy, that was dangerous. Lapierre was standing still. Had he not been able to get that puck, it was a two-on-one going back the other way.
Ryder stops the puck, this time makes the play to Tanev. His cross-ice pass is right on the stick. David Booth, Cassian missed it at the blue line. Now he's got a chance for a do-over, and he dumps the puck in. Muzzin to Doughty. The Kings break out. Justin Williams, wing wide to Dustin Brown. Over to close the ice on him is Garrison. And Hamhuis with a nice outlet pass to Henrik Sedin. Daniel threw the puck to the open wing. Quick is out to meet it, and he couldn't quite hang on, and Burrows was right there. Garrison trying to hold the puck in and can't do it. Through the middle comes Anze Kopitar. Williams is with him, so is Brown. Garrison up the boards. Burrows can't clear the defensive zone in the midst of an LA change. Now Burrows ahead for Henrik Sedin. He's got Daniel with him. Two on one. Daniel shoots. He scores. A Vancouver twin killing, and the Canucks have the lead again, 3-2.
The danger when you get sucked in offensively like the Kings were there, a bouncing puck in the offensive zone. Voinov got sniffing offensively. Look at 26, tried to keep it in, couldn't do it. Clifford thinks he's got it in, Voinov stays, and look at the heads-up play by Henrik Sedin. Snuck behind everybody, two-on-one, made that quick pass, and just an absolute perfect shot. A goal scorer's goal, 14 inches, stick side, right underneath the blocker, right underneath, over the pad, and Daniel Sedin continues his hot streak.
He's up to 8 goals now. Henrik Sedin and Alex Burrows get the assist at 16:08 of a wild second period.
That's one play for Scuderi. He was just a little too far gapped. He was back. And a smart play by Henrik Sedin. Often you'd hold that one, but he saw the passing lane was open, and Daniel makes the perfect shot.
Canucks out at center again. Higgins with a little shoot-in. He's with Mason Raymond and Yannick Hansen. Scuderi is back. He and Doughty paired together. That's been a rarity lately. Scuderi gave the puck away. Yannick Hansen walks to the front of the net. He shoots, and that went off a stick just wide of the net. He ran hard into Kyle Clifford. Scuderi. Richards at center with Carter. Doughty's up with him again. Kevin Bieksa is back. Steps in front of Jeff Carter. And got the puck to Alexander Edmund. Higgins. An outlet to Hansen. He had to knock it down. Bieksa's up with it. One-on-one against Ellerby. Takes the shot. Big rebound off the blocker of Quick. Cassie had his helmet knocked out over his eyes, but he can still see. Or maybe not. That was picked off. And Jarrett Stoll races back the other way. Takes the shot. Skewed wide by Chris Tanev. Booth couldn't get the puck out of his own zone. Stoll keeps it in with a shot. Trickles towards the front of the net. And Alberts is there to clear it. Here comes Max Lapierre. Booth speeding to join him. Takes the pass. Cassian's in front. He wanted the puck. He was tapping his stick. Booth didn't get it to him. And he takes the shot. The quick stop. End-to-end action now in the late stages of the second period. Cassian steps in front of Drewski. Lapierre there to help out. And the puck comes loose. And the play is going to be stopped here and a penalty called.
They're both going to go.
They're both going to go?
Yeah.
Max Lapierre. And Jarrett Stoll. Coincidental minor penalties here. Max Lapierre for interference. Jarrett Stoll for diving. Here's the goal that Vancouver's Daniel Sedin scored.
Well, you see Henrik up at the blue line. Now Richards comes on for Kopitar. He had no idea that Henrik was behind him, so he's late to react. and a heads-up play. It turns out to be the go-ahead goal. Here's the two penalties. Stoll loses the puck, gets a shoulder on LaPierre, and the call that LaPierre went down too easily. So both go. Neither player liked the call.
So 4-on-4, and Henrik and Daniel Sedin are on the ice. It's the other way around. It's the interference on Stoll, the dive embellishment on LaPierre. Henrik Sedin for Daniel. Drew Doughty is there. Kopitar's on the ice with Dustin Brown. So lots of talent out here, 4-on-4. Jake Muzzin battling behind the net. Daniel to Henrik. Garrison was in front. Henrik for Daniel. That was going to be pretty. And Kopitar takes over for LA as the Sedin start a change. Jake Muzzin. Dustin Brown. Kopitar falls in behind him. Kevin Bieks is there for Vancouver. So as Mason Raymond didn't quite get the puck out, Scuderi kept it in.
Yeah, how at the end of that shift, Henrik goes over and gives a shot to Kopitar, too. That's a good hard work shift, a lot of battling.
There's Yannick Hansen with a little bit of room, scores! He just about lost the puck altogether, but he still got the shot off, and Vancouver has a two-goal lead. Yannick Hansen gets the goal.
Just some beautiful shots that have beaten Jonathan Quick, and this one in the middle of traffic. They're almost losing the puck there, but watch in the middle of three players. Just turns in the middle. Scuderi can't get his stick there, and he moves it side to side in a quick release in such a hurried fashion that the goaltender doesn't get set. Look at it, he gets control of the puck, and in one foul swoop, backhand, forehand, top shelf. Great hands and a lightning quick release. At that point, it's not how hard it is, it's how quickly you can get it away and the positioning, and both were perfect.
Raymond and Hanhuis will get assists on that goal by Yannick Hansen. To tell me you predicted all these goals. We thought maybe 2-1 tonight. That's usually the Western Conference, isn't it?
And their five-game winning streak, the Kings have given up a total of 6 goals.
4 tonight, and we're not at the end of the second period. 4-2 Vancouver. Still 4-on-4. Here's Richards with Carter at center. Plays broken up by Edler. Now Alex Edler has the puck to the open. Alex Burrows on the right side. Higgins drives the net. Drop pass. Bieksa shoots. Going off quick and into the corner. Back the other way. Justin Williams. Bieksa gets back in a hurry. And Williams is on his own as linemate Richards needed a change. Thrown out to center. LaPierre's return to the ice with Jarrett Stoll. In almost the last minute of this second period. David Booth with Max LaPierre shovel the puck back. Dan Hanhuis fires a shot that's blocked by Williams, and Trevor Lewis takes off. Justin Williams, drop pass, Drewski is there. Booth got to him in a hurry, and the Canucks get the puck back. Zach Kassian got it out to center. Slava Voynov. Davis Drewski takes the puck off the boards and up the middle. Here's Williams. Colin Fraser. Lewis goes to the net. The puck went on goal and Schneider stopped that. Lewis back to Voynov. Fires a shot. A nice save by Corey Schneider there. Kassian can't get the puck out of his own zone. Jordan Nolan comes on. Jake Muzzin pinches in. Holds the puck in for Los Angeles. He's backed up by Kyle Clifford. A forward is back as the Canucks get out. Henrik Sedin chipped the puck in and then got hit and knocked down. And Drew Doughty's going to get a penalty for that. An interference call. Very similar to the call on Jason Garrison earlier in the game.
And both players don't like the call, but this one is one where Henrik's dumping that puck in. Doughty's got a split second to make a decision.
Los Angeles penalty, number 8, 2-minute interference.
And that has been the way that's been called. You saw Garrison with the one arm that got it. Doughty, his reaction to that, he thought he did it simultaneously. But instead, a power play here, which real chance for the Vancouver Canucks to take this game over completely.
Better win the draw, though. There's only 12 seconds left in the period. And the Kings get it. They'll clear the puck. And that'll do it for the second period. So really, this turns into a third period power play for Vancouver. Just their second of the game. The Kings have had 4. And before Alex Burrows can shoot, the period comes to an end. Vancouver outscored LA 3-2 in the second period after getting one in the first. It's a 4-2 lead for the Canucks on Hockey Night in Canada.
At Rogers Arena, what a pleasure it was earlier tonight to see longtime voice of Hockey Night in Canada, Jim Robson, drop the puck with your protege, Jim Hewson, especially with you wearing the regulation powder blue. How many of those jackets have you had?
Oh, three or four, but this doesn't fit anymore. I noticed that. But it's great to be out there with Jim Hewson, who's the best in the business.
Jim, let me ask you this. Hockey Night in Canada is the longest-running sports production in the world. What did it mean to you to become one of the principal play-by-play callers on the program?
Well, it was a great thrill for me, and I got to do some big games. I, of course, like to have done even more games, but it was a wonderful thing, and all my family was excited for me, too, so it was a special time.
You know, your powers of recall are razor sharp. I'm sure you remember every detail of the Kings' victory over the Canucks October of 1970 in their first ever NHL game here.
It was a long, dull night. The Kings won 3-1 in a so-so game, and I'm sure the people in Newfoundland were fast asleep by the time the third period came around.
Jim, thanks for your time. It's great to see you again.
Thank you very much.
All right, now back to the Jim Robson broadcast gondola for the call of the third with Jim and Craig.
All right, Scott, thank you, and you too, Jim. Drew Doughty's in the penalty box here, so Vancouver starts this third period on a power play for just about the duration of it. They've got a minute and a half with which to work, and they have a 4-2 lead. They lost three in a row at home. They've been all business tonight, and Kevin BX has been a big part of it. He got the puck deep. Davis Drewski sent it down the ice. Sedins have been excellent. The players the Canucks needed to step up have been real good. And now we'll see if they can finish this off. Here's Alexander Edler with Alexander Burrows and Daniel Sedin. Burrows turns away from Drewski. Edler takes a wrist shot, quick to save, rebound. He stopped that off Alex Burrows. Canucks have four goals on 17 shots on Jonathan Quick. Here's Kopitar up the middle. Bieksa read that and held the puck in. Rob Scuderi whacks at it, trying to get it out. And Bieksa raced to it to hold it in.
And Jim, that one shot, he just bobbled. It's been sort of a night for Jonathan Quick. Not quite settled, not quite on his game.
You got to give the shooters credit.
Yeah,
but
some really good shots.
But it is Jonathan Quick, and he doesn't usually let in many. Here's Daniel Sedin. Zach Cassian takes a bump from Clifford. Hamhuis, side of the net. There's a shot by Cassian, and he stopped. Looking for his first goal in a while. Cassian, number nine, relays the puck into the corner. Mason Raymond. Jason Garrison takes a hard shot, and he just missed the net. Dan Hamhuis. Bounced by Daniel Sedin. Mason Raymond has a couple of points in the game. And he's double-teamed there, but Hamhuis holds the puck in, takes the shot, deflected wide. Cassian hustles to it. Off the boards to Garrison. Back down into Zach Cassian. Across the ice, here's Hamhuis. Penalties over. Higgins up the middle. Garrison's shot just wide of the net. Great puck control, and Cassian just took a run at it, just missed Keaton Ellerby. What a good-looking power play without results.
A real sense of purpose again. All the good short support passes, quick puck movement. They did everything but put it in the back of the net.
And that's their game, isn't it? When they're on, lots of passes, lots of accurate puck movement. Here's Yannick Hansen. Winds up and fires, and that ended up in the corner. Might have gone off the skate. So 5-on-5 again. Quick can't stop the puck. Penner to Jake Muzzin. Drew Doughty to Carter. Carter and Richards are both -3. Andrew Alberts is back. And here comes Chris Tanev. Slides the puck ahead. Darting to it. Jordan Schrader takes a shot. Rebound off a leg. Came right out front, and there was a nice chance there for Tom Sestito in his first Vancouver Canuck game. Here's Jarrett Stoll the other way with Dwight King and Trevor Lewis. Couldn't backhand the puck to the front of the net. That was stopped by Garrison. He turns, gets away from being double-teamed. Sestito with a backhander. Didn't get it out, but he'll get some help from Jason Garrison, who does. Dale Weiss played the puck back to his defense before he left the ice on a Vancouver change. The Canucks have had the puck since they came on the ice to start the third period. And they've got it again. Sedins have come back on with Alex Burrows. Daniel to Henrik. In comes Alex Edler. Curls just tips the puck through. Daniel had a look around, feeds the puck around to Edler. Up against Trevor Lewis, the puck got through Henrik Sedin with a slap pass to Burrows. Keaton Ellerbe is there. It's been keep away here for 4 minutes, hasn't it?
I like, again, the aggressiveness in the offensive zone. The D are still pinching down, but pinches that are safe ones with good support.
Dustin Brown trying to get something going for the Kings. Justin Williams turns away from Henrik Sedin, and again, Kopitar. Williams snaps the puck to the net. It's loose and kicked away by Corey Schneider. Now Drew Doughty on the other side. Jake Muzzin. Great pass to Williams in front of the net. Kopitar was covered there by Alex Edler. Williams and Brown can't come up with a puck. The Canucks do. Daniel Sedin, the exit, joins them at center, dumps the puck in and heads for the bench. Both teams make a change here. Drew Doughty to Jake Muzzin. And up the middle to Colin Fraser. He was checked in the neutral zone. Long pass for Hansen. Was in the air and he let it go by. Muzzin is back and there's an icing call against Vancouver, but they had just made a change.
Well, I mentioned the fact that for Jonathan Quick, it's been one of those nights, a lot of traffic in front. There, he thinks he has that shot. The rebound ends up hitting him in the mask. And then another one at the other end. Watch the stick of Edler get right up close into the face of Brown. No call made there. And you know that the Kings will have a little push here. They've won twice this year when trailing into the third period, and the way that second period went, you know that the action can heat up quickly.
There's a draw. The Kings look like they had. They've won 60% of the faceoffs, but another example there of how you can still get possession if you hustle off the draw, even if your team loses it. Slavo Boyle. Tip in by Colin Fraser. Dan Hamuse against Kyle Kiffert along the boards. Canucks using their fourth line regularly here in the third period with a two-goal lead. Voinov bobbled the puck at the blue line. Dale Weiss is right on it.
And a smart play. After the defensive zone faceoff, Jim, as soon as Vigneault saw the lineup for the Kings, he made the change on the floor. Get them some valuable ice time in the neutral zone.
Jordan Nolan just got out of the way of a hit from Tom
that was
Sestito.
Close, wasn't it?
Colin Fraser's poke check by Hamhuis. Davis Drewiski with a long shoot-in, handled by Corey Schneider. Coming up on Tuesday night, Rick Mercer learns how to prevent ice jams in Manitoba. Then it's no-holds-barred political comedy on 22 Minutes. That all starts Tuesday at 8 on CBC-TV. Five different Vancouver Canucks have two-point nights. They have a 4-2 lead here, 1-0 after the first period, and outscored the Kings 3-2 in the second. To the front of the net, Jeff Carter looking for his sixth straight game with a goal, and he just about had it there. Had a chance for it. Jake Muzzin. Starts out with a pass to Jeff Carter. Richards is with him up the middle. Dustin Penner's on this line. Now there's a centering pass. Nice sliding block by Chris Tanev.
One thing that Vancouver's done a nice job of, Jim, is not allow the Los Angeles Kings possession.
Here comes Carter. Backhander stopped by Corey Schneider. And Jeff Carter, the minus three tonight, a chance straight up the middle here, but he's stopped by Court. Time now for our Hockey Night close-up, brought to you by Subway Restaurants, and we've done this quite often, featured the Sedins in this segment.
Well, Henrik to Daniel, how many times have you heard that? Perfect place shot, the celebration from his brother's big goal, but then the effort down low. Good hard work in that second period, turning this game around, battling down below as they do so well, support each other, the cycle back, and Henrik spinning around Muzzin, and then at the end getting after Anze Kopitar. It's been a good, solid, hard-fought, aggressive game again by the Sedin brothers.
Just what you want from your team leaders when you've lost two in a row and three at home. But the only thing the Kings have really dominated in is faceoffs, and we kind of expected that. Jared Stoll in for Trevor Lewis. Lewis, King, and Stoll back together again. They were a fixture for a lot of the playoffs last spring. Zach Cassian to Max LaPierre. Long shot in on Jonathan Quick, and he stopped it somewhat uncomfortably, and he decided to hang on.
Well, right now, you look at the way that the Vancouver Canucks were able to change that second period. I think Mason Raymond's goal was the key one. When the Los Angeles Kings were putting the pressure on, they had a 2-1 lead, and Raymond just turned the momentum around. And you think of asking a player to play a position he's not comfortable with. Alain Vigneault asked Raymond to do it. He's resulted in what was a really big goal to turn this game around.
Canucks win the faceoff. Alex Burrows, stick handling, wrap around up front. Henrik Sedin is there, so is Daniel. The wraparound didn't go in, and the two Sedins couldn't get the puck in front.
Well, Jonathan Quick almost put himself in two there in the splits. Burrows out-deked himself.
Line's had some really good shifts, hasn't it? And they've played almost exclusively against Anze Kopitar, Dustin Brown, and Justin Williams tonight. Daniel tripped over the blue line. Point off his back. Williams to Kopitar. And back, Justin Williams. Kopitar to the net, and he just missed that. Keaton Ellerby threw the puck at the net, tipped right on. Williams was all alone in front of the net. And maybe too close. Schneider got out to him and made the save.
Well, that really accentuates how important this goal might have been for Burrows. He makes a great play around Voinov and then just can't quite get it. Look at the athleticism of Quick going side to side with his legs. A complete split gets across and a loose puck he's able to clear away. And somehow in front of the Vancouver net, look at Williams all by himself, left wide alone. And a key job by Schneider holding on and getting that rebound.
Jonathan Quick is ably backed up by Jonathan Bernier, who's had a wonderful start to the season. And this team has 17 games and 29 nights, and they're going to need both goaltenders. It's a good thing that Bernier has played so well. Same for Vancouver. 16 games and 28 nights coming up in the month of March. No practices, just games.
And Bernier, the restricted free agent next year, a lot of eyes watching his progress this year. 4-1, got pulled in his first game, but he's been dynamite since.
Colin Fraser, Jordan Nolan, Kyle Clifford out here for Los Angeles in the attacking zone against the fourth line for Vancouver. Severed by Jordan Schrader with Tom Sestito. Yeah, and Dale Weiss.
That's something Los Angeles hasn't been able to establish, though, is that territorial advantage. They've been one shot and out for a stretch in the second period. They started to really control the offensive zone. But since then, in the turnaround, they've been in and out of the offensive zone for Vancouver, unable to establish that pressure.
1-3-4-minute stretch. See how they make out this time. Dustin Penner in forechecking against Jason Garrison. And Hughes off the boards, and they're safely out to center. Yannick Hansen with Mason Raymond dumps the puck in. Drew Doughty, first man back. Flushed out by Raymond in a hurry. Here's Richards starting back the other way. Carter's on his right, Penner's on his left. He shoots the puck in, Ham Hughes is back. Up the boards, Muzzin pitched down along the boards and held the puck in, and he's got it again. Out to Penner, couldn't get the shot away in time. Higgins got to him, and Garrison clears the puck to center. Drew Doughty to Jeff Carter. In the midst of a change, Jarrett Stoll comes off the bench and dumps the puck in. Dwight King in for checking, and giveaway by Schneider, thrown at the net. Jarrett Stoll again out front, and Lewis had the puck go off the toe of his stick. There's Dwight King. Jarrett Stoll moves to the front of the net, now in to take the cycle. Alex Edmund up the boards. Rob Scuderi holds the puck in. Batted out of the air by Alex Edler. Kevin Bieksa shovels the puck up the boards. That's three tries, and Vancouver hasn't been able to get out, and now Max LaPierre lifts it in the air to get it out.
You wonder if Schneider will stay in his net a little bit more. That was another close call after the Nolan goal. That one, Jared Stoll tried to throw it in front from Van Corner.
Might need a tether.
To keep this going for 8 minutes, won't they? Try to end the game along the wall.
They need a new puck. No harm done. A lot of time in the attacking zone for LA, but all on the boards. past the midway mark, third period. Vancouver ahead 4-2. Anze Kopitar winds up and carries the puck in, passes off. Williams got it out of his feet to the net and deflected in behind. Hammies got hit there by Dustin Brown. Here's a 4-on-2 the other way. Daniel Sedin, Alex Burrows. Drew Doughty slid into and knocked him down. Daniel got to the puck. Henrik looking for Hammies, who was coming off the point. Daniel takes over. Jake Muzzin hasn't seen much of this from these two. Look at that dangle. Henrik centering. That was stopped by Jonathan Quick. Burrows to Daniel. Hamhuis just kicked the puck back in there. Muzzin will be dizzy. So will a few others with the way this shift has gone. Henrik stops. Got the puck away from Doughty. Daniel. Burrows is in front. Henrik couldn't quite take the puck. Finally, Muzzin up the middle. Williams can't get it out. And the Kings ice it, and they're dead tired. That lineman trapped in their own zone. A terrific shift for the Sedin line.
You have to wonder whether Daryl Sutter will take a timeout after that display. Look at Roberto Luongo laughing. Yeah, here comes the timeout for the Los Angeles Kings. Just confidence, quiet confidence and strength and composure. Henrik controls the puck. And as they do so often, Kopitar gets puck watching. He makes an embarrassing play there. And Henrik does it to Doughty as well. When you get tired and you get chasing, that's the end result. You've got to focus on the middle of the body. He wanted it from his brother Daniel there, didn't get it. And that ended the play with the icing.
Henrik Sedin in his 601st consecutive game looks pretty fresh. He's also got 95 playoff games and he hasn't missed one.
Well, pretty impressive numbers. The franchise leading scorer. He'll be on after hours quickly with Scott Oak and I after the game. You almost wonder, geez, could you put Henrik back out there in the timeout?
Yeah, I could almost do that.
Let this line have to deal with them again. If this is a tight game, you probably would have.
Two-goal lead face-off in the attacking zone, and the Jordan Schrader line gets out. Here's Justin Williams. His line mates are changing. And he got poke-checked to the blue line. Cestito. Canucks have a game tomorrow night in Calgary, so it's important to get the fourth line some minutes and back off a few others, and they've been able to do that because they have the lead. Here's Chris Tanev. Davis to Whiskey, and Kyle Clifford plays the puck back to him.
Really, when you're looking at that fourth line role, that's all you have to do is eat up a good 30 to 45 seconds, keep the play moving forward, try to keep it in the neutral or offensive zone and not get hemmed in. It allows your coach that flexibility of putting you back out there again. Good, safe shift.
The Schrader line has just finished it. They've done exactly that. Here comes Jordan Nolan. He's hit hard by Andrew Alberts. Pierre to Bieksa. Gets the puck out to safety. Jonathan Quick will have to play it. Skideri's there. Voinov back to Skideri. Richards tips the puck in with Penner and Carter. Alberts is back, gave the puck away. Richards hard centering pass. Carter missed it. From the blue line, Voinov shot is stopped by Schneider. Bouncing puck for Carter. Penner can't get a shot. In comes Skideri. Voinov, big crowd in front. Skideri to Penner. He shoots. What a save by Schneider. Here comes another one. Schneider again makes the save off Voinov, and he's got the puck. And he's got the fans to their feet. Kings pushing to get close, and Corey Schneider makes two of his biggest saves of the game.
Closes the gap on Penner and actually gets his foot, knocks him down, and gets after the rebound. Good aggressive play off the rebound. Not sitting back in his net and allowing Penner any time or space.
He was real hard on himself after the loss to Phoenix, and you could tell he really wanted to play tonight and get back into the net.
Yeah, he hasn't been happy with giving up three or more goals, and this has been a game where he made the one mistake behind the net that cost him the second goal, but he's been sharp.
Alexander back. Carter, Penner, and Richards right back out there for Daryl Sutter. They need something soon. Penner Here's Voinoff. Mike Richards. Penner turns and fires that one off the toe of Corey Schneider into the corner. This line's bound and determined to get the Kings close, and Carter takes the puck away again to Penner along the boards. His pass hit the back of Chris Higgins' leg, and he'll get a chance to get out, dumps the puck in, and a change coming up for both teams.
Justin Penner started to get his legs. I mean, you think about Darryl Sutter, the way he handled him early on. Didn't play him in 7 of 8 games after he played the first two, and tonight he's rewarding him for some good, steady, hard work and play.
Here's Jarrett Stoll. Trevor Lewis is driving the net. The centering pass went off a stick right to Max LaPierre. Now he takes over and passes off to David Booth. He's got Cassian over on the other side. Can't get him the puck, nor can he get it in deep. And so the play goes offside. 4-2 lead for the Vancouver Canucks over the Kings, who've won 5 in a row. You're watching Hockey Night in Canada.
2 more points for Henrik Sedin tonight as he continues to build on his all-time franchise lead. The Canuck captain will join us briefly on After Hours tonight until he has to get on the bus to head to the airport for the flight to Calgary. And then we'll spend the rest of the time advising Mike Gillis on what he should do to help the Canucks win the Stanley Cup. And my guess is that Mike can't wait for our expertise.
Oh, Jeff. I'm certain of that. Looks a little more relaxed tonight, though, than he has in the past couple of games. And a 4-2 lead with 5:40 left in the third will do that for you. Last couple of shifts, LA's been pretty good here. But they need something out of this very soon if they're going to make a tight game of this.
Well, you would expect that from the Cup champs. They've tried to turn the tide, and Darryl Sutter's been pushing his bench pretty hard, too, getting the guys out there who've been playing well. And again, in an offensive zone, Alain Vigneault happy to get another shift from that fourth line. And that's good bench management, as you were saying, especially with a back-to-back.
Jarrett Stoll won the draw. Keaton Ellerby up the boards. Dwight King starts the breakup. Stoll has Lewis with him. Tried to feed him the puck, and Alberts broke that play up. Panev is the first man back. Alberts there with him. On the other side, Keaton Ellerby aggressively in along the boards to Trevor Lewis. He's got King in front of the net. Got Stoll now circling, wanting to work the cycle, and the Canucks. Tanev broke the play up, and out to center starts Sestito. Takes a hard hit from Drewiski, but got the puck in deep, and that fourth line is hustling to get off the ice again. Just off the bench, Jason Garrison across the ice against Lewis. His line mates are changing as well. Dale Weiss flipped the puck to center. Just to finish the change, Muzzin up the middle. Dustin Brown mishandled the puck, and here comes Henrik Sedin. Got Booth with him. The pass went off Drewiski. Booth with his head up to the blue line. Garrison's shot got through, but it's caught by Jonathan Quick, and he hangs on. Coming up Wednesday on CBC, Jerry meddles in a couple's relationship on Mr. D, and on Arctic Air, an old romantic flame is reignited amidst the search for a missing boy. That all starts at 8 on CBC Wednesday. Sedin and Kopitar, nose to nose again. Daniel stops up, tried to feed Burrows, that went off a skate. And out starts Dustin Brown. Can't get by Dan Hamhuis. Muzzin and Doughty. Not many teams can do it, but the Canucks have won this first line matchup tonight against the Kopitar group with the Sedin line. And they've been, maybe had one of their best games of the season tonight.
You could tell the intensity was there.
Yeah.
You know, Henrik and Daniel working hard. Burrows with that great play that got started in the backhand pass to Hamhuis. But to me, it's been the winning the little battles all over the ice.
Here's Drew Doughty. Jake Muzzin and out to center. Jordan Nolan to Colin Fraser with Kyle Clifford just onside to the net. Easily steered aside by Corey Schneider. Nolan. Rob Scuderi just holds the puck in intentionally wide of the net. A wraparound comes out front off a skate. Nolan can't get a good shot away. Look at all the Canucks in front of Schneider. Behind the play, there's a shoving match. Fraser and Alberts, they break up as Cassian gets the puck deep into the LA zone. Scuderi quickly back the other way. This could be a 3-on-2. Nolan to Fraser to Clifford. Couldn't get the shot away. Forced to the outside. Fraser had his pockets picked by the artful Dodger Max LaPierre. Fraser again to the front of the net, and Nolan missed that. Skinneri. Kyle Clifford. Back to Rob Skinneri into the middle. Screen shot. And Corey Schneider just dropped down and absorbed the shot and stopped the play with under 3 minutes to go in the third.
Well, Frazier was all over that shift for the Los Angeles Kings. Some great battles. But watch Tanev, an excellent effort down below as Nolan keeps it alive, battles in front. You could see Alberts and Frazier going after each other. And Alberts has been all over the body all game long. They go at each other and the referees allow it to go. And the play by Tanev here, look at getting back. Good desperation play. All you got to do is get a little stick on stick and he stops the play there.
And the play is stopped again. Dowdy's shot is stopped by Corey Schneider. Chris Tanev's amazing. You know, at the end of the night, you look at the stat sheet and he won't have any shots on goal. He probably won't have any hits. But he's so quietly efficient. All the other guys want to play with him because he's so good.
Alain Vigneault heaping praise on him, on a young player who's really learning to play a role, a specific role, not overplay the situation. And he's been a great find.
Yannick Hansen trying to chop the puck out. Couldn't do it. He'll get another chance. That's in the midst of a change. Drew Doughty is back. Muzzin, hard pass to Jeff Carter, takes a hit as he got the puck deep. Richards along the board. Garrison stepped in front of him. Mason Raymond is back to help up. And he goes off the boards, out through center safely. Just working the clock now. Voinov, rink wide off the boards. Nobody wanted to touch that puck because there was a change in progress.
You gotta give Mason Raymond some credit for having a game where he's got to play a position he's not familiar with. Struggled a bit in the faceoff dot, but he's played well down low in his own end. Contributed with a goal and assist, and really answered the bell for his team.
Point off at center. A little trouble here against the Sedins, but they got ahead of the puck and the play's offside. Down to 1:49 left in the third period.
Now the question, Jim, is how long can that go? I mean, the one thing when you lose a guy like Kessler, you look down your bench for Alain Vigneault and he just doesn't have that strength up the middle that you could have. And that, even when you look across at Los Angeles, what they've had. But when you get a guy coming in and playing an unfamiliar role and doing an excellent job of it early on, you just hope you can continue to maintain that kind of a level of play out of him.
And if the goaltending gets back to the way it has been most of the season, they could be okay.
No goaltender here for Jonathan Quick. Yeah. Why not? I guess two goals, you need it.
Kings pull their goaltender with a minute and a half to go in the third period for the extra attacker. Anze Kopitar to Drew Doughty. Going to weave his way through all this traffic. Bounces the puck in. His partner Muzzin is up on the plate. Tanev is back. To Daniel Sedin. To Henrik. An open net caught from behind almost. And a rink wide backhand pass to Alex Burrows, and he couldn't get the puck to get a shot of the open net. Williams chips the puck in. Down to a minute to go. Chris Tanev bounces the puck to center. Doughty's back to get it. Davis Drewiski. Six attackers dump the puck in and go after it. Dan Hamhuis calmly back. Mason Raymond defending in this last minute to Hamhuis off the boards. And a good battle there at the blue line for Yannick Hansen to help the puck out. Slava Voinov back the other way. Dumped it in and Hamhuis will flip it in the air and get the puck right back out to center. Drewiski's long shot in went off a leg. Higgins to the empty net. Dead center. He handled that like he had no question that it was going to hit the middle of the net.
Yeah, he had pretty confident. He also knew you've got a two-goal lead, only 20-plus seconds left. Not a bad play. Be a little embarrassed if it goes wide and you get an icing call, but a confident shot, almost dead center, that puts this game in the books. This is a good statement game for the Vancouver Canucks. Daryl Sutter, his team goes back home now for five more. And their one road trip sandwiched in between eight home games has not been a great one.
Yeah, they've had to play 11 on the road so far, and they probably like having some home games, but maybe not so many all clustered together. But such is this shortened season when all the buildings were booked. Vancouver had lost three straight at home.
Well, the one thing for the Canucks, too, is they've been avoiding the long losses. I mean, they had one stretch where they were 0-1 and 2, but they've been avoiding the three straight losses. The dreaded losing streak is gone. Corey Schneider answers the bell with a solid game as well.
Yeah, he certainly wanted that, and he performed well. But the leaders took over in front. Five different players with two-point games, including the Sedins, who had a terrific night. And Vancouver has a 5-2 victory over the Stanley Cup champion Los Angeles Kings. The Kings got 30 shots on goal, but only scored twice, and Vancouver scored five on 24 shots at Jonathan.